Welcome to Gull. If you've purchased the accompanying visual guide, please open it up to page one. We've also provided a potential walking route to enhance your experience of this show.
You are also, of course, free to peruse the visuals and activities provided in the guide in your own time.
However, we do suggest Gull is listened to in one go rather than incrementally.
So please, relax.
The rest of the world is far away.
Please turn off any notifications or sources of disturbance during this performance.
This show contains potentially upsetting content and discussion of sexual abuse and consent issues. Please take care of yourself.
Please, do not feed the birds. This could make them very sick, and even potentially very angry.
Well, enjoy.
Oh, no seagulls were harmed in the making of this show.
I work in my kitchen. It's on the ground floor. It's the brightest room in the house. In fact, it's got the only working overhead light. I do a lot of my work at the kitchen table. I don't like to work in my bedroom, and I don't like to stay in the office late. It feels vulnerable. And people think you're trying to display something, like I'm trying to say, oh, I'm in the office late, I deserve to be here. I've already established a pattern anyway, and I'm worried about people seeing me and asking,
hey Ava, why are you working so late? Don't you usually go home at 5? You always go home at 5.
You know what I mean? It would be off-putting. It wasn't much of a problem previously, but I've been pretty busy lately. I work at the dictionary, the Oxford English Dictionary. I normally work on research, etymology. I add new words. I mean, I don't make them up. I find ones that are starting to be used, and I guess I endorse them. People always ask me what I would add if I could just make them up. I tell them I don't know, but it makes me think about it a lot. A dictionary is a pretty powerful tool. I should probably add words like decolonize or double consciousness or emotional labor. Maybe I would add slang terms, but that's not the question I'm being asked. Those are words I want to endorse, but they already exist. If I was just creating words, well, slonking. Just slonking in the library. It's studying or working, kind of has this impression of leaning over a table. Normally I'm just doing research, sending emails, stuff like that. But the powers that maintain the dictionary are looking for us to expand into some outreach avenues. So one day at our morning meeting, my boss Grace came in and said,
we've been doing the whole give poor kids a dictionary thing for too long. It's outdated. The internet exists. The powers that be want something new. I want to see pictures. Esther, book the conference room for January 20th. That's pitch day. I want to see new, snappy outreach projects. Think global. Think young. Think sexy, yeah. Sexy social issues that you think the Oxford English Dictionary can solve. I'll circulate an email with more information.
And Esther said to me,
that sounds perfect for that thing you're always talking about.
And I didn't realise it at first, but she was so right. This is a dream of an opportunity. I've been talking about a large-scale project on gendered language in English for years now. And Grace loved it. Launch day is fast approaching, so now I'm swamped. There is nothing worse than an opportunity in that way.
Esther.
Answer the phone, Ava.
I'm not sure if I can make it. No, I feel sick. No, I'm busy. No, I have work to do. No, I'm sick. really, really, really sick.
Ava!
Fine. Hey, Esther. Happy birthday.
You knew it was me?
Who else would ring 4 times in a row?
So your phone is working?
I was in the bath.
Any essential oils?
Yes.
What type?
Pine.
Pine? You had a bath with pine essential oils?
Lavender, I meant lavender.
You meant lavender.
I always mix those words up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. If you actually look into the etymology of it,
fine,
you'll actually
okay.
see...
I believe you.
Good. Well, you should.
What time are you coming over this evening?
Well, you know I hate to do this, but...
Ava...
It's just, I'm not so sure it's the best environment for me right now. I've been doing so well and I'm just trying to focus on myself and...
Don't make excuses, Ava.
I'm not trying to.
You know you'd enjoy it. Ella from accounting will be there. And Brian. Brian thinks you're the smartest person he's ever met. And some of my friends you haven't met yet, who are dying to meet you.
It's not that I don't want to go, Esther.
Jesus.
Sorry. That was too much.
It's my birthday. And I'd like to see you.
I just feel sick.
Don't start with the I feel sick.
I know. It's not real sick.
I didn't say that.
We both know what I mean.
It'll be... normal.
Okay. Right. Dara isn't coming?
No! I mean, I invited him out of courtesy, but he texted me to say he won't make it. I don't think he's even in the country at the moment.
All right. Good. Yeah. I'm coming. I want to. I have the most gorgeous present for you.
Come over now.
I have to shower.
Thought you just had a bath.
Yeah, I was in the bath. But, But, well, baths don't really clean you, do they?
Oh, sure. Well, don't be late.
I won't be.
I start getting ready at 1 p.m. I think it will take longer, but the house is set. And I'm ready by 6. I call Ava to make sure she's coming. I'm not stupid. I know there's something going on with her. There always is. But it doesn't help to treat her like glass. She wanted to come anyway. At 8, the doorbell starts to ring. I check the mirror one more time. I look fucking fantastic. I'm already a little bit drunk. I spend 5 days a week booking meetings and taking calls for a bunch of articulate fucks in that office. It's my birthday tonight. And Fiachra's coming. And this night is for me. Once it gets going, it starts passing so fast. There's pushing and dancing. Wine spills on me, on my white dress. This girl is turning to apologise to me, and I'm fuming. She's spluttering. And I realise it's Ava. She's here. We both just start fucking laughing. So hard. Our cheeks are sore and red. She's spitting out, "Sorry, sorry, sorry." And she's pushing this big, gaudy, gold wrap present into my arms. I say I'm sorry too. We're crying then, I think. I tear off this awful gold wrapping paper to find Christmas paper underneath with tiny snowmen. It's wrapped in layers. I shout, "It's just like Pass the Parcel," into her ear. And we both keep ripping and ripping and ripping and ripping and ripping until we get down to a tiny little jewellery box. I open it up. It's a ring with a big, disgusting orange rock. It's the exact sort of thing I wear. Ava is falling over herself. She gets down on one knee to propose to me and almost gets lost in other people's long legs. Fiachra, gorgeous Fiachra, who I've been looking for all night, appears out of nowhere to help her up. But I grab her off him and she comes easily. This is our time. Around us, people are still moving to the beat of the music. I tell her I've never seen her so drunk. And she tells me she's never seen herself so happy. I think I've done a good thing for her. I don't see her again until 5 a.m. when I'm ushering everyone out my door. And she looks a little bit lost. She starts to cry. When I ask if anything happened, she just shakes her head manically. Oh, I think it might have all been too much. We both crawl into my bed and sleep till 2 p.m. After which, she excuses it as drunk girl crying with an awkward laugh. It's not that unusual of an occurrence. I decide not to push it. We spend the rest of Sunday together in a casual, hungover silence. It's our usual cohabitation. We make dinner. Every half hour, I convince her that she definitely hasn't left her kitchen window open. She doesn't need to go home and check. We watch Gilmore Girls. She finally goes home at 11 p.m. on Sunday night. We both just about recovered, which is good. We have work tomorrow.
This way, this way, this way.
Noel, can we please just rest?
No, look, in here. We need to find somewhere for you, Pippa. Somewhere proper.
I'm fine. I just...
Look, here.
Here could be good.
It's cold.
The window's been open for a while.
Looks deserted.
Yeah, the fridge is empty. Do you think anyone lives here?
Not judging by the dust. Maybe it's a holiday home?
In Lucan.
Well, there's nobody here right now anyway. Should be good for getting us nested and getting you rested.
I like it.
What should we call it?
Nothing. There's nothing to call it.
Thank you.
Noel was the one who spent the night gathering up a hefty number of twigs and grass. I was in the kitchen, building and layering up our nest. We chose a spot right in the far left corner, tucked away from the cold windows on top of her cabinet. We found porridge oats and milk that was just barely in date, and had porridge for dinner. We were cold and wet and tired, and my wing was still so sore. Noel kept telling me not to worry, but we both kept looking towards the door. But no human materialized all night. When the next morning came, I was still nervous of a human coming, but by late afternoon, I figured we were in the clear. Lots of people have deserted homes like this. Anyway, I needed somewhere to rest. Noel leaves again in the evening to find more food for dinner. I stalk carefully through the kitchen, peering at the few knickknacks collected there. When I hear a key in the door, I expect panic, but I stand on the kitchen table with a sort of resigned defiance.
I know how to walk home. I always walk home alone. I've been living in the opposite direction from my friends in a pedestrianised household my whole life. I know how to head down, earphones out, keys in hand walk home. I know posts online tell you to be attentive, be safe, no earphones in kind of walk home, but I am so scared and such a daydreamer. I daydream all the time. Sometimes it's more vivid than real life. Most of the time it's more real than real life. Esther would ask me what I mean by real, but you know, don't you? You know. For this to make sense, you need to know that I'm daydreaming. All the time. It's about being reclusive, about jetting off, about cooking delicious meals in quantities way too big for one person, and about eating them anyway. About there being nobody to text when you're on your way home, and about that not being a scary thing. I leave Esther's in a daze, but I'm struck by how dark it is outside. I walk slowly till I'm out of sight. Then I sprint for 2 minutes straight. Walk for 2 minutes straight. Sprint, walk, sprint, walk, sprint, sprint, sprint. It's like a fucking beep test. I live a lot of parts of my life with their fucking exams. On the good days, I see nobody. I'm just fearful of potential passers-by that never materialise. Some nights there are shouts in the distance. There are boys hopping over walls. There are late-night dog walkers. Why do they walk their dogs so late? Are they not afraid? Are dogs afraid? Are there any animals that are afraid of the dark other than humans, than me? Bad nights have people who say things to me. Who walk behind me, who shout, who laugh, who sometimes even grab. This night is not a good night. I'm stopped by one group of boys. They have the deepest echoing howls and hands full of Heineken. Stopped is the wrong word because I keep walking, but they shout a bit and they linger a bit, and the group dissolves just enough to occupy the width of the path so that I have to walk through them. I clutch my coat tighter. The wind is loud and cars whine loudly. They might have said something to me. I couldn't quite make it out. The rest of the walk is uneventful, but my heart is pounding. I'm daydreaming so hard that I almost take the wrong turns in streets I grew up in. The hum of traffic alongside me allows me to associate myself with a revving car engine. It is a little heartening. I walk the rest of the journey with a key clutched between my two fingers with no earphones in. They are cold and light and hard and fit well between my fingers, but I do not in fact know if I'm being smart or anxious. Probably both. I shove the keys into my door, put the keys down. I'm met with warmth when I step inside. The porch light has been left on. I don't read the newspaper today after a glimpse of the headlines. I do not check my phone or text Esther. I'm not worried she'll call. I know she's forgotten.
I'm going straight to bed. I'm on autopilot. I'm scared of my own steps, of the sounds of the floorboards. I walk straight into the kitchen. The light is on. I can hear the wind whistling outside. Shit, did I leave the window open? I stand motionless for a second outside. There's nothing. No sounds, no movement. It's dead quiet. I say, there's nobody in there. It's barely audible. I realize I'm saying it to myself. I don't know where courage materializes to push open the door, but it materializes nonetheless. I open the door and... Oh my God!
There's a seagull in my kitchen!
Yes. We're staying up there in that nest.
Holy fuck. Oh my God. This is my kitchen.
Yes.
Please leave.
I can't right now.
Why?
My wing.
Oh. I see. This is my kitchen.
I see that. Noel!
Oh, gosh. We come in peace.
No, don't...
We come in peace.
No, calm down.
Fuck it. Fuck, how many are there?
Oh, just us.
Do not be afraid of us.
No, sit down. You're scaring her.
Please. I don't want any trouble. I need this space.
Sit down. Everyone, please, sit down. Shh.
I can't handle this right now.
No, maybe we should just...
She's hurt.
What?
No.
She's hurt. Like, really legitimately hurt. She can't fly. Look at her wing. It needs time. We can't stay at the beach or on the river. It needs to heal.
No, we probably shouldn't.
How did you hurt it?
Some kid on a bike.
Ran you over?
Ran straight into me. I guess he thought I'd fly away.
It's broken. Is there like a seagull hospital or something? A vet?
That's not really an option.
She needs somewhere safe. To stay.
And that's my kitchen.
Safe, warm, sheltered.
You guys won't hurt me.
We're birds.
You're seagulls.
Yes, we won't hurt you.
You guys will stay in here, in the kitchen. Just in the kitchen. You won't invade anywhere else.
Just until my wing is fixed.
Okay. Just, all right. Stay.
Oh my God. Thank you so much. I could kiss you.
No, honey.
Just please let me sleep. It's so late. I'm so tired. Just let me sleep.
Do you want supper?
I don't eat worms.
Neither do we. Here, have this. It's fresh honey.
Let's make some toast to accompany the honey.
Yeah, okay. Where did all this food come from?
House 242, 254, and 268.
You stole it! You're stealing from my neighbours!
Stole is an incredibly strong word. I'm a bird.
This is surreal.
How about we all introduce ourselves? I think we're getting off to a bad start. I'm Pippa, and this is Noel.
Ava.
Nice to meet you, Ava. Thank you so much for letting us stay. Please, sit down. Let's have some supper together. I'll make pancakes.
Pancakes? Yeah. So, you stole this food. How? I mean, this is a lot of food. Don't they notice?
Again, I think stole is a strong word.
Did it not come right from their kitchens?
Stole implies ownership.
It was in their kitchens.
Location does not imply ownership. And anyway, who's to say they owned their kitchens?
No need to be so hostile, Noel.
I'm not trying to be hostile. It's just hard to explain things like this to humans.
No, look, I get it. I understand the whole property is theft thing, but this is straight off someone's kitchen table.
Well, we've got pretty much no alternatives. It's not fair to call it theft. I'm a seagull.
What do you mean?
Humans decided they were the ones with the God-given right to own property. They are the ones who decided their homes were permanent. That they owned the food they farmed, but we didn't own the eggs we laid or the nests we built. If this is the only way we can eat in peace, then so be it. I don't believe in eating on a guilty stomach. And I don't feel guilty at all.
Jesus, okay. I wasn't trying to start anything.
Neither are we.
Did anyone see you?
I'm a bird. Nobody's going to call the police.
No.
Sorry. I'm being snappy. I'm hungry. Take this pancake as a peace offering.
Mmm. This tastes so good.
Does that mean you don't disapprove?
I never said I disapproved of it. Look. Thank you. I'm gonna go get some sleep. Good night, Pippa. Noel.
Good night, Ava.
Good night, Ava. Good night. Okay, right. Let's get you to bed too, Pippa. How's the wing?
It's hard to tell, exactly.
What do you mean?
Well, it feels really sore all the time.
But you're used to it.
Exactly, so it's hard to tell how it's developing. I'd like to think I'd notice if it was much worse, though.
Well, that's a good sign. I hope it's healing, oh dear. Do you want some tea?
No, I have a feeling.
What's the feeling?
I think we should probably get out of here.
Pippa, don't be ridiculous. You can't fly.
No, I'm serious. I don't think that she...
Please, don't do this to me, Pippa.
What?
Don't stress me out about this. I'm so worried about you. It's just like you to downplay your pain. To insist you aren't hungry when you are. To try and fly on a broken wing. To try and stand your ground when there's a human child on a bike speeding towards you. It hurts me too when you're like this, Pippa. I can't handle it. You need to be cared for right now. It's okay to be...
I understand that,
but... No, you don't, Pippa. And anyway, normally you're the one who's eager to nest in strangers' houses. To steal their food, to shit on their floorboards. What's gotten into you?
I just... I'm not sure.
Stay put for another little while. She already knows we're here. She said we can stay. Maybe everything will be fine. We can figure out everything. Please, Pippa, just stay. I hate to see you like this. I love you so.
Okay, shh, don't panic.
Right, sorry. Sometimes I get too emotional. I'm too much.
Don't turn this into a... I like you as you are. Okay? We'll stay. She seems nice.
You'll stay put?
Right here.
All right, okay. Good night, Pippa.
Good night.
Oh, you're up.
Good morning, Ava.
Breakfast is served.
Did you sleep okay?
Yeah. Wow, this is a lot of food.
We didn't know what you like.
We stole it, but it's from a lot of houses. They won't notice. They would have thrown half of it away. You shouldn't think about it.
I won't.
What breakfast foods do you like? So we can know in future.
Right. Well, I guess I really like fruit. Especially when it's fresh. I feel like I can never eat enough fruit. Aren't you supposed to have like 5 a day? That seems like an immense amount of fruit. I especially like freshly squeezed orange juice, and I love having a mandarin to nibble on during the day. I actually really like knowing the exact difference between oranges, clementines, and tangerines. I take an unusual amount of pride in it. Jesus Christ, sorry. I'm really rambling. I don't think I'm that good a housemate.
No, that was good. We liked this.
So, what are you up to today?
Well, I have to get to work. I'm actually sort of late as is, so I should run.
We'll be here for you later.
Thanks. Right, bye.
All right, everyone. Monday morning brief. I hope that you all had a good weekend. Now, let's get straight into it.
Everyone, I've thought of this really great new word, and I honestly think it could make it in next year, so...
Charming, but not pressing. Ava, the launch is next week.
We should be all ready to launch. Most of the things are printed, most of the guests are confirmed, I've got the speech prepared as well, and...
You know, if you need any help, I'd be happy to give you a hand.
Everything should be fine.
Okay, well, that's good. Esther, has the catering and printing been handled? Everything's booked?
Yes, all bookings are confirmed and deposits paid. I checked this morning.
Could you just quickly show me? Let's go for a chat.
Right, yeah.
Hey. Ava. I had fun on Saturday.
Please, don't talk to me about it.
Ah, come on. I was thinking we should go for drinks sometime.
Fiachra, I was drunk. I was so drunk.
No, you're just trying to back out of this because Esther is obsessed with me.
What? No, I was drunk, okay? I don't want to talk about it.
Brilliant. All right, everyone. It looks like we're in good shape for the event. Now, this is our first large event since Dara left and I took over. And of course, he will be back for the launch, and I suppose that...
He'll be back?
Of course. All the ex-editors have been invited. It's a big deal, Ava. I hope you're excited. Anyway, there are just a few more updates and briefs that I need to go through.
The rest of the day passes in an absolute blur. Fiachra is constantly cornering me. He sends me text messages constantly. Sometimes they're about work. Sometimes they're lewd and suggestive, and I feel so deeply uncomfortable. I can't talk to Esther about it either. I turn off my phone. I walk home slowly at 5 p.m. I gingerly push the key into the door. I don't take off my shoes or coat. I get into my kitchen. It's deserted, but I can hear sounds of feathers ruffling in the next room. I sit at the kitchen table under the fluorescent light until I become self-conscious. I'm being weird. I open the fridge door and
seemingly hundreds of oranges fall out. Noel!
What?
Why is there so many oranges here?
Well, actually, technically, most of them are mandarins, and some of them are tangerines.
This is too many oranges!
Humans eat a lot, and I wasn't sure how many was too many. Though, I have to say, I am realizing that this does look like too many. I appreciate that.
For fuck's sake, Noel!
What's going on in here? Oh, I see. There is too many oranges.
I was trying my best. You said you liked oranges.
It's okay, Ava. Don't be angry. It's better to have too many oranges than too few oranges. We can give them away. It's okay, it'll all be fine. We can get rid of them. We can...
No! No, it's not okay. Because you think you know a fridge. You think you know a fridge, and then one day you open the door, and without even asking you, hundreds of oranges or tangerines or whatever just will tumble out. And then what do you do? Huh? You thought it was just your normal fridge, and then it does this? Then what do you do with your fridge?
I'm sensing this is not about the oranges.
It's not. What's going on, Ava?
It's all just... a lot.
Noel, can you give us a second?
I really didn't mean to bring home so many oranges.
Noel...
Okay. Right. Sorry. I'll get some chocolate, some juice.
A normal quantity, please.
So, what was that all about?
It's really complicated, I think.
I want to know.
It's really complicated, you know, it's never like he did anything really explicitly bad. I mean, he did, but it's hard to just...
An ex-boyfriend?
Yeah. Dara. Mm. And there's also this boy, Fiachra, who sort of, well, he's rude and invasive. And he just reminds me of it all, and I don't know. It's not like either of them did anything really explicitly bad, but basically what happened, I guess, was...
You don't need to explain the specifics. Tell me how you feel.
What do you mean?
Well, what did it feel like?
I don't know.
At all?
Do you know how Carmex feels?
I don't have lips.
It burns. You know, it's lip balm that burns just a tiny bit, but you never think of it as sore. Or waxing. Or heels that strain your ankles. That strain pushes right up to your shin. You know, false eyelashes that dig into your cornea, it's almost pain. Like when you don't use the bathroom for hours and it starts to burn a little bit. Or when your earring just about snags your hair. Or when you put one foot in the bath and it's just a bit too hot.
It's sore, but you're used to it happening.
I think that's it.
Would you like an orange?
That's a mandarin, but yes, thanks.
Here you are.
What's weird is it happened like really, really gradually. And I was really, really young when we first started going out. But I just felt so invaded afterward. Really ghostly. And being around him makes me feel like that, you know? Not safe, not real. Ghostly.
You know, everyone hates seagulls.
Yeah.
But really all we do is survive. We just swoop for food. But what they really hate is that we're good at it. Really, quite good at it. We are really, really good at surviving. People hate it. Oh my God, they hate it so, so much. They despise our growing populations, our aggression. But I mean, you're the ones who created the conditions that made us. It's crazy how everything can be your fault. I mean, one seagull fights a baby and suddenly... Oh, sorry. I'm getting off track. What was I saying?
I don't know.
People hate us for taking up space, Ava. They wish we weren't so good at adapting.
I think he's coming to my campaign launch. He's an ex-editor at the place I work.
At the dictionary?
Yeah. At the dictionary.
That's bad.
Yeah.
He's probably really articulate too. Not that you aren't too, just that some people use their words to spin things, weasel out of things.
I don't want to talk to him.
To Dara?
Yeah. I want him to disappear.
What about the other boy?
Fiachra? I don't know. I just want to...
Lie down and let him treat you poorly.
That's not it. It's hard. It's not my fault.
I didn't say it wasn't hard. I didn't say it's your fault.
What do you think I should do?
I'm not sure.
Well, great. This is useful.
Maybe you should talk to a human about this. Maybe you should tell Fiachra to fuck off. I don't know, if it were me, I'd poke him with my beak until he vomited up his food so I could digest his nutrients. But humans don't do that.
Yeah, we don't do that, but thanks.
Anytime.
You know, Esther, most people text before they ring. It's a generational thing. Most people don't even ring doorbells if they're outside your house. They text if they're outside your house.
I'm excited. I have a plan.
What's your plan?
I think I'm going to ask Fiachra out. I'm just going to do it. It's time. I have to. I'm a grown woman here. I don't need to pine for him like this.
Oh.
What?
It's good you called. It's good I answered. I have to tell you about something.
Oh. Well, okay. My plans can wait. Talk.
Do you remember your party?
The real question is, do you remember any of my party?
That's kind of what I want to talk to you about, actually.
Oh.
Something actually happened between me and Fiachra that night, but I...
No! Like... No, you didn't!
Hear me out, please. Just calm down, please. Yeah. Okay, I'm sorry, but I didn't... I wasn't comfortable. I was so gone.
Oh no, Ava.
And he won't leave me alone. He keeps texting me all the time. Look, I'm sending you a screenshot.
Image sending.
Fuck.
Yeah.
This is Fiachra. My Fiachra.
Yeah. Your Fiachra.
Reply and tell him to fuck off.
Esther.
No, I'm serious. Reply and tell him he's a little wank stain.
Esther, seriously, what do I do?
Punch him.
I don't want to be near him. I don't want to poke him in the belly till he vomits so I can digest his nutrients.
What?
Can you handle it for me? He might actually listen to you. You're scary.
You can withhold his room bookings and printer credits.
I'll handle it.
I love you.
Yeah. Love you too.
Are you mad at me?
Why would I be mad at you?
Because, you know, you like him a lot.
Ava. No, I'm not. I'm just a bit disappointed.
In me?
No! In him. Or me, maybe.
You're jealous.
Maybe. But, you know, there's a little part of me that wishes I was the one he was fucking viciously pursuing. I would have told him to fuck off, of course. But it's hard not to think of it as a compliment.
Are you jealous of me?
I know it's not right to be, Ava. I've read Feminist Ethics for Dummies.
It's not your fault if you feel like that. You feel how you feel, you're programmed to.
But what I'm feeling right now is ugly feelings. Ugly thoughts that I have to be accountable for.
Don't beat yourself up.
I won't.
You will handle him, though?
Of course. Yeah.
Thanks.
No problem. Just...
What?
Why didn't you tell me earlier, Ava? This is so embarrassing for me.
I was finding my feet.
What do you mean?
You have to feel grounded to do things like that.
Well, where did you find your feet?
Hey, Esther. Would you be able to run these down to the printer? I'm just pretty swamped, and you know how I always appreciate when you're able to help me out.
Oh, you have some fucking nerve.
What?
Don't play dumb.
What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about.
I'm an editor, not an actor, Esther.
Ava!
What about her?
Leave her alone. Stop texting her. Don't talk to her. If you need to talk to her, send me a memo. I'm not just the receptionist, but apparently your assistant too, so I'm sure it'll be fine.
This is none of your business.
It is if she says it is. You're sexually harassing her. And you fucked her while she was too fucking drunk to move.
Look. No. Don't be ridiculous.
This isn't a joke.
You fucked up!
Okay! Okay. Jesus Christ. It wasn't like that. She came on to me.
Just leave her alone, okay? You're not worth it.
Fine. Fine, okay. Now, could you print these for me? Or
unbelievable!
The weeks ticked on. We ate breakfast and dinner together in the kitchen. They're the best roommates. We cook and they dance and we laugh. They love each other a lot. I felt like they loved me too. But one day I came home and... What's all this for?
It's dinner.
Well, it's more a dessert.
For you.
It's more like a feast, and the decorations, wow. Guys, what's the occasion?
Come on, sit. Let's eat.
Your wing looks good as new. As the night ticked on, I realised what the occasion was. They didn't mention it, but this was a goodbye. Pippa's wing was better. They wanted to return to nature. I'm not proud of what happens next. That night, I crept down and shut my kitchen window for the first time in months. No birds could get in or out. When I came down the next morning, they were gone anyway. I'm not sure how, but they're gone. I move on. The launch date is looming closer and closer. I somehow tell Esther about what happened with Dara. She cries. She says she's sorry. She didn't know. She's sorry she invited him to her party. She drags me to a meeting with Grace. She assures me that there's definitely no way Grace will invite him if I tell her. I don't want to have to talk to my fucking boss about it, but we do.
How are you feeling?
Nervous.
It's fine. Grace is a good person. She hired me even after a particularly awful interview. She'll understand.
She can be so cold.
It's a formality. She takes everything seriously. She's worked hard to get here.
I get up at 6 a.m. every morning. I eat pre-prepared porridge with fresh berries. I do an hour on the treadmill, and then I shower, get ready, straighten my hair. I do my makeup. Not enough to be obvious, just enough. I know how to do my job. I know how to be an editor-in-chief, how to command, how to be in charge. A dark, slimming pencil skirt, a bright blazer, and learn to walk in heels. Cut people off, but do it with a smile. I have always thrived day to day, playing the game, doing the work. The hardest part of my job has always been hiring. You're really making an investment in someone. You're not welcoming them into a family. We all say that, but we all know that's not what it is. It's more like a relay team. See, if one person runs slower, the next person has to run faster. And I don't like to break a sweat. When I hired Esther, well, she was a spluttering mess. But even a monkey could answer the phones and work the printer. She kept looking at me like she had something to prove. You see, she's a college dropout with a lot of unexplained career gaps. I knew that she'd work hard and stick to her position. And, most likely, never leave. And I've been right, so far. Fiachra, well, honestly, he had a lot of family connections. But he's bright, and he works, if he's challenged. Ava was hired straight out of college. She's clever. She works diligently. Lots of good ideas and, well, I would love for her to succeed. But she's never willing to push. You have to be willing to push to get to the top, and I can't push for her. You have to move with purpose in a field like this. You have to have intention. And I feel like Ava just drifts. See, she seems like she has ambition, but she packs up her desk at 4:59 every day and practically bolts down the stairs. Oh, well, that's another note. Always take the lift. You can meet people in lifts the way you can't on the stairs. Come in.
Hi, Grace. Do you have a moment to chat?
Ava, my absolute star. Come in. To what do I owe the pleasure of?
Hi, Grace.
Oh, Esther. Is everything all right? Do you need signatures?
No.
I was actually hoping to talk to you about something. It's semi-serious, and Esther's here as some support.
Right. Okay. That's not quite company practice. You'd usually go through HR.
I've actually gone to HR about this issue a few times. They weren't too helpful. Just hear me out.
Right. Well, come in. Sit down. Tea? Esther, could you get us all some tea?
Right. Yeah, I'll do that. A dash of milk, right?
Yeah.
Ava?
I'm actually fine.
Are you sure?
I'm not feeling too well.
I'll get you some water.
All right. Ava, what can I do for you?
It's about the launch event next week.
And what about it?
You mentioned the previous editors are coming.
Yeah. It'll be the biggest day of your career.
And that includes Dara.
Yeah. He's very excited to come back for a visit since he left a few months ago. He worked here for years.
All right. So...
Okay. One tea and one water. Here you are. Ava, I got you some painkillers too.
Ava, what is this about? This is highly unprofessional and I have a meeting at 2.
Well, you know our history.
Yes. I'm aware that you were previously intimate.
Yes. And you know that I've filed complaints against Dara in the past.
Ava, this is not suitable.
I know. It's just... He wasn't good to me. He makes me hurt. I can't launch the campaign with him there.
Ava, I really hope that you're not going to ask me to bar the previous editor from the launch of our campaign on arbitrary grounds.
They aren't arbitrary.
Ava. Look. I like you, okay? You work well. You're smart. And I'm sorry that he makes you uncomfortable, but I can't do anything.
He doesn't just make me uncomfortable.
Ava, I'd advise moving on from this. I won't be able to grant your request. Unless I see a court-ordered document, there's very little I can do. He doesn't even work here anymore, Ava. Don't let this cloud your vision.
Grace, I can't be around him. It's...
Look, I can't do anything. If you want to, you can take it up with HR.
We both know they won't do anything.
Well, I'm sorry, Ava, but this is work. This is what work is like. We are going to extend an invitation to Dara. If anything... It might harm your career if we don't. He's still a powerful man.
These specific circumstances
are... Forget about it, Ava. Just take a break. Go and gather yourself together. Esther, get back to the reception desk.
Grace, there has to be something we can do. Isn't the safety and comfort of our staff our number one priority? Isn't that what it says on the About section of our website?
Look, if you don't want to do it, Ava, we can ask Fiachra to launch it. He can make the speech.
Fiachra?
Yes.
I'm not letting that happen.
Well, good. It's your project. Now, I look forward to the launch.
I leave. I should have left then and there, but that's not how real life works. I launch the campaign, it goes well, but then I'm back to emails and meetings and research and... I don't care anymore. I start using my LinkedIn profile again. I leave. I hand in my notice and Grace tells me she'll miss me. I leave. Esther... cries, says she will miss me. I love her, but I think I might have hated it there. I get a job copy editing for this tiny magazine called Groove, and I even write the occasional article. The pay is half nothing, so I work part-time in the storeroom of a bookshop, but eventually I become a cashier, and it's nice. And it's good. I put out bird feed every morning, and half-cut bits of fruit. Birds gather, they look at me, and I look at them.